Are programming jobs still in demand? Let's talk about that in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And the question was again, are programming jobs still in demand? Well, the short answer is absolutely they are. But today, things are getting a bit more competitive. Back when I started out, it was quite common for a programmer to understand and know one programming language, and that would be enough to get them through almost their entire career. So back in the late 70s, early 80s, when I was starting, I know that sounds like a long time ago, COBOL and Fortran were the two programming languages. So if you knew either of those languages really well, you would have a solid career and have lots of options available to you as a programmer. So these days in 2019, you need to be a little bit more multi-skilled and have your eye on the future. So you can't really just close the closet door and just sit back and know just one programming language and never be prepared to learn something else. So in other words, you need to keep your skills current to make sure that your ability to get jobs is going to be there for the future. So what I recommend you do is certainly learn the basics first. And if you know a programming language, a popular one like Java, Python, C++, or Go, or something along those lines, then that's a good start. But I would recommend you also multi-skill. So learn some frameworks as well, and also try and learn more than one programming language. Now, that's not to say you need to spend 24/7 on this. You don't need to, go nuts and spend 6 hours a night or anything of that nature. But it does, investing in you, in yourself, is really important for the long term, for your long-term career. So the more time you invest in yourself, and investing in yourself is learning different programming languages, frameworks, and those sorts of things. So the more you do that, the greater the likelihood that you're going to succeed and have options available to you if something changes. Because the thing to remember is that moving forward, technology is advancing at a rapid pace. And you really can't just pigeonhole yourself and have just the skills in one programming language and not be prepared to change. Well, you certainly can do that, but you're going to limit your future career opportunities by doing that. So I'd learn a couple of programming languages and have a look at the areas that you're focused on. If you're an existing programmer, maybe you're writing mobile apps for the Android platform, as an example, and maybe you're using Java, and that's great. There's nothing wrong with doing that, but can you learn Kotlin as well? Could you learn that as a second language? Or if you don't want to learn any more about Android app development, maybe you can look at iOS and Swift and try and get those skills just to diversify a little bit, and knowing that that's going to be more valuable. To an employer when they're looking through your resume. Or maybe you can start looking at other areas just to hone up your skills a little bit to make sure that you're ready to go. So basically what I'm saying is that the more you can learn without going nuts, I'm not talking about learning 20 programming languages, but if you've got two or three, that's going to really make you more versatile and ultimately make you a much more employable person. And that's going to really increase the likelihood of a long career, and obviously also make sure that you get really well paid. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.